So this is a pretty tough question. If you weren't able to get it yourself, that's okay. What I'd encourage you to do is to stop in the middle of the explanation once the part where you got stuck on makes sense and see if you can finish it yourself. So what we need to do is define a function. So we're gonna define a function hash string, and it takes two inputs, the keyword and the number of buckets. And we're gonna keep track of where we are in the circle. We need to introduce a new variable to do that. And we should start at position zero. So we'll initialize that variable. We'll use h to represent the hash, and we'll initialize that to zero. Now we want to go through the characters in the keyword. So we'll have a for loop that goes through each character in keyword. And for each character, we want to add to the hash. So we're going to add to the hash the value of that character. We could do the modulo here. So we could, at this point, use modulo buckets. We have to be careful to have the parentheses here. If we just had the modulo buckets here, we wouldn't get the right result because it would do ord c modulo buckets. What we really need to do is modulo buckets, the sum that we get from h and ord c. And then at the end, we're going to return the hash value. We could, instead of doing the modulo each time here, we could do the modulo just once at the end. That would be computing a big number if we have a really big string. And then at the end, compute it modulo buckets. Either way should work. This way is a little better in the sense that if our string is very long, we would have to compute a really, really big number, which gets to be more expensive, and we might even run out if it's a super long keyword. So it's better to do the modulo here. We'd get the same result either way, though. Let's try this in the Python interpreter. So here's the code that we wrote out on the sketchpad. We have our variable h, which is going to keep track of the hash value. We're going to go through all the characters in the keyword, adding each one into the hash value, modulo the number of buckets. So let's try the examples. So A with 12 buckets hashes to bucket 1 as we expect. And if we look at B, it hashes to bucket 2, also as we expect. So one other thing we should try, if you remember when we had the really bad hash string function, one of the many problems it has was it didn't work on all strings. In particular, it did not work on the empty string. Do you think our hash string function here will work on the empty string? So try to guess what the result should be before I run it, and then I will run it. And you see the result is zero, so no error. And it makes sense that the result is zero. We start with h is zero. When there are no characters in the string, we don't go through this loop at all. So h is still zero when we return. And let's also try the longer example. When we hash the string Udacity with 12 buckets, we get bucket 11. We should be able to increase the number of buckets. So let's increase the number of buckets. Let's suppose we had 1,000 buckets, and we get bucket 755. This isn't enough to convince us that our hash string function is distributing all strings well between all buckets, but at least we're getting a fairly large number that says we might be using all the buckets.